relied on nothing less than his own kingdom. A lone American conquered the world of high fashion and beat the French at their own game. Yet the toasted palace arrived penniless from Mississippi to trade grits for glitz. The incredible success story of Patrick Kelly. High of his is the ultimate grits to glitz story. He hitched his way out of a dirt poor Mississippi backwater and headed for Europe's chicest capital. He was broke. He couldn't speak a word of their language, but he had an eye for style and dared to dream. And Patrick Kelly taught the French a lesson in fashion design. Now he ranks right alongside Cardin and Givenchy. The most faded American in Paris will never forget the day he saw the light.
When I was a little kid, my grandmother used to work in wealthy homes in Mississippi, and she came home with a fashion magazine. And I don't think I was even 12 years old. I know I was a kid, first grade or something like that. And I flipped through the magazine, and I was amazed that this was a magazine that only had fashion in it. And I knew then that's what I wanted to do. I knew Paris was supposed to be the capital. That's what you always read, even in American magazines. So that was my big thing, is to come to you. I didn't have much money, so I went to all my friends who had any money, and I said, look, give it up. Because I'm going to you, and they can say, he mad. I said, I'm really mad, but I got this ticket. Now I need some money. And then it came in really good. I mean, I came in.
As a nobody without a sou, he got the French kiss off from the snooty Paris fashion houses. He peddled handmade duds in the flea markets, but barely scratched out enough to eat. His big break came when Patrick plucked up the courage to say, voulez-vous couler avec moi?
Was from Mississippi, a black from Mississippi, was quite a reason. And so I made big fried chicken dinners from 250 people to up to 1,000 people. It was a catering service, and we made a lot of money. And we take that money and invest back into our own collection.
His hot and spicy southern-style chicken, served by his ooh-la-la model gal pals, turned over just enough gold cash to launch his first Buttons and Bows collection in Elle magazine. Overnight, Patrick Hu became Monsieur Kelly, the oddest thing since, well, since sliced snails. He set up shop in a trendy neighborhood and was snapped up for a multi-million dollar contract by the huge Warnaco company. Determined never to let success go to his head, Patrick refuses to relinquish hands-on control of his hard-won operation. He shrewdly pays all his own bills, and just as a reminder of those hand-to-mouth days, still keeps a bed right under the design table.
You still struggle. Even with big cars, you still have to work hard. You know, to be honest, you have to maintain it. I mean, I don't think I could serve just fried chicken. Now if I want fried chicken and potato salad here, it's a normal day. But I know that the days are long here, but happy.
Behind the trademark sneakers and overalls is haute couture's sharpest cookie. Flanked by just 17 fiercely loyal full-time staff, he generates over $10 million a year from his seven boutiques. The former chicken fryer from the Deep South soundly plucked the French fashion world and left it in a flat. He's the first American designer to be honored by the ultra-elitist Chambre Syndicale. And on his way to racking up success, he even learned to parlay Francais. His styles poke fun at much the French hold sacred, and they love it. Even with headline clients such as Madonna, Princess Diana, and Betty Davis, Patrick says the ultimate test is whether his creations turn a Frenchman's head. Patrick bought his family a dream home back in Vicksburg. It was his way of thanking them for encouraging him way back to dream the impossible dream.
I'm not too dreamy. Once you think you've already made it,
French at their own game.
From our Vicksburg Bureau.
Patrick Kelly grew up in his house on Military Street. Today, he is a Paris clothing designer. And Time magazine calls him Mississippi's smash hit in the tough world of high fashion. Friends and neighbors aren't surprised at his success.
He was very much interested in designing when he was a small kid. He designed some like shoes and also some of the clothes that he's designing today.
Patrick is a good example of the rewards that anyone can receive, regardless of how poor they may be.
According to a Time profile, he is one of only 43 designers who may show at the Louvre, the famous Paris Museum. In clothes, Kelly is known for being outrageous, but an ex-principal says he has always been that way.
Patrick was an original guy. He was a little different. I can remember back in high school, kids used to poke fun at him.
And that original guy from Vicksburg is now selling $7 million a year in clothes. Jim Mayer, WJTV, the News Center, Vicksburg Bureau.
Patrick Kelly's trademark is buttons because his grandmother used to sew different buttons on his clothes. That was all she had, and now he's made a fortune doing it. Interesting.
Very, it is very interesting. We were out speaking today.